We have a surprise! We're having a baby! It's a baby right there.
Since we've got married, we've been praying for a spring 2020 baby. And God is faithful. We've been blessed to be pregnant at the right and perfect time. And we're going to be expecting a baby in the spring of 2020. I found out on Monday, it was Labor Day, and he was in Missouri. And I was, you know, setting up, getting ready for him to come home. I was making him a poster, the Welcome to LA poster. And I don't know why. I just decided to take a pregnancy test. And I had taken some, you know, we've taken some in the past, and it was like negative and negatives. But all of a sudden, I'm like, I started like reading things on Google, people on YouTube saying, just buy one at the Dollar Tree, you know, stop wasting your money on these expensive negative tests. And
let me tell you right now, Clear Blue, do not use Clear Blue. That's a zero star.
I bought like 4 boxes and they all said negative. But anyway, so I listened to these girls on YouTube. I went to go buy some pregnancy tests at the dollar store. I was like, you know what? I'm not going to waste my money anymore on those stupid Clear Blue tests. Let's buy some at the dollar store. So I bought like 4. But I don't know why. Like, we're going to go to the airport to pick up Jers. And then I decided to go to the bathroom and, you know, take a test before. And so I took it and I left it there and I went to go, you know, set up for him, get ready for him to come home. And I went back to the bathroom and then I saw 2 lines and I was like, I didn't even know. Like, I was happy. I was shocked. I couldn't go tell my mom. I couldn't tell anyone. I couldn't call anyone. I wanted him to find out first. Yeah, it was just surreal. And I was like, I couldn't sleep that night. I was just like, it was just like, I don't know. It was just, it's hard to explain that feeling. I'm just so happy. So before telling everyone, we wanted to make sure that our family members knew, and we try to make it in a very special way. And before all my family members, of course, I had to surprise Jerson because I wanted to make this special surprise for him since he made an amazing proposal for, you know, he made an amazing
proposal. It was I.
Then when we got married, it was amazing. So I wanted to make sure to surprise him in an amazing way too. So I had no idea what to do. And I was thinking about it all summer because I knew we were going to get pregnant either June, July, or August. Like, for a fact, I got you a Guns N' Roses shirt. It was like a Sweet Child of Mine, kind of like the one he has on right now. And I got him a Kobe Laker jersey.
Cool.
For goat, baby. This goat, is all baby the stuff. Goat. And I also got him a Champ in the Making WWE onesie. So I had all 3 outfits for a baby all planned out, but I just needed something else. So I went to Guitar Center and I found a baby guitar. What was it? A baby guitar?
A baby Taylor.
There you go.
If you're a guitarist, you know Taylor. That's the way to go, man.
I just want a small guitar because it's for the baby.
It's mine too. It's mine too.
So I was like, I'm going to get
but
it for
it's mostly
the baby.
Baby.
And I literally planned this all overnight. I went to go buy some buns at Target. So I got hamburger buns and I was thinking, what I do with these hamburger buns? So Saturday morning, I woke up really early and I told him to get ready. So I blindfolded him. We drove to this park. So when we got to the park, I got all my bags that I had. Then I started to open up the buns and then I made a heart, like a huge heart with all these buns. And then I put them right in the middle of it. And then I went to go set up the onesies. And then I went to go set up the guitar. And then I also had this really cute card. It was like an avocado one. So then afterwards, I was getting so nervous because I had no idea what I was doing, honestly. I was like, and then just in general, all my emotions started like running. And then I feel like I was going to start crying. And I was like, I can't cry. And I haven't even said a word to him. He's going to be like, why are you crying? So then I walked him over a little closer to me. I got the guitar. And then I just had the guitar on my, you know, on my hands, kind of like if I was proposing to him. So I got on one knee and then I told him to take off his blindfolds. And I just was there on one knee.
Hey, guys need to be proposed to as well.
He loved it. I just knew the instant I spoke, that was tears. I was just so happy and overwhelmed with like joy. It was amazing. Because I knew it was like real. Like I was keeping this like secret from him for a whole week, and I wanted to tell him like so bad. Like that whole week, I wanted to tell him something. Like I just want to turn around and be like, "I'm pregnant." I was happy. It's surreal. I sometimes still can't even believe like there's a heartbeat in my.
I do remember Jess acting a little strange that week. So the week ended, and it was a weekend. Saturday morning, Jess told me to wake up. It was early. So I got up. I was a little cranky and stuff. So Jess takes me to this place. Oh, and now I remember what you said. It was, oh, Jerson, put a blindfold on because I want to take you somewhere. So I put a blindfold on, and in my mind, she said something like, there's going to be people there. And there's possibly going to be parents taking their kids to do this activity as well.
Oh, because so, it was a park. I thought there was going to be a bunch of kids running
around. Yeah, so in my mind, I was like, what's going on? I can't stand being blindfolded. But Jess had me by the hand. And there was a moment where she was even like, Jess, can you walk holding these two bags? And I'm like, okay.
Oh, I couldn't hold these bags.
Woman, I'm blindfolded. And that's I don't know where I'm going. I'm a trip help. On something. And it was uphill. You know, I was anxious to get that blindfold off. And as soon as I remove my blindfold, I see Jess in the middle of a heart of hamburger bun. Right at the bottom of her, there was three onesies. In the middle also, there was a baby Taylor, which is a guitar. And on it, there was also a card. As soon as I saw all of that, I was in shock. But I didn't know how to react because I didn't know if this was true. But I remember I was like,
"Yeah,
are you sure? Is this real?"
Yeah, I'm gonna do all this as a joke.
It was a real deal. Jess was asking me to be the daddy of the baby that she's carrying. Obviously. Obviously, that's my child.
I wouldn't want anyone else.
So I remember seeing Jess, and she said, "Will you be the best daddy to our baby?" And I saw her kind of tear up a little, and I was still lost. I was just super excited, so super excited that I kept talking to Jess the whole way back to the car once we cleaned up and stuff. And I accidentally left the car keys in the car locked. But I was just so happy that me and Jess were finally gonna be parents, something that we've been both wishing for a long time.
We're going to be parents.
We're going to be parents.